Hello, I'm Dae Kyu-jung. I'm going to present the work Cyber Sickness Analysis with Ease using Deep Learning Algorithms. Before we start, I'd like to show you a short video clip. This video shows a scene for experiencing 90-degree dive Draken roller coaster in Korea. Did you feel motion sickness watching the video? If your answer is yes, do you remember when and why? You'd probably believe that you do. However, are you sure that your memory is accurate and objective? In the past, a survey with questionnaires was the mainstream to measure the motion sickness. However, since a survey relies only on human memory, the used information might be subjective. Using subjective information might lead to incorrect measurement or analysis. In this work, our goal is to find an objective approach of measuring motion sickness and to analyze how and why people feel motion sickness while experiencing VR. This is an overview of our approach to measure and analyze cyber sickness. First, we collect EEG data using Emotive and 4VR headset. Then, we pre-process the gathered raw data for the learning. The deep learning algorithms, such as DNN and CNN, are used. We employ a visualization technique and analyze VR video sequences to examine when the cyber sickness occurs. The table shown in this slide summarizes the data that we have used in this work. We collect 14-channel EEG data over various bandwidths. Total 100 attributes of EEG data are collected at each sampling time. We recruited 24 subjects, including 13 males and 11 females, for the EEG data collection. In here, signal quality indicates the sensing quality of the EEG signal provided by Emotive. We used deep learning techniques for the data classification. This slide shows the DNN structure that we have been using. The DNN structure has a ReLU activation function except for the last layer. To determine whether a subject feels cyber sickness, we utilize the sigmoid activation function for the output layer as it produces 0 or 1 as an output. We have divided 24 subjects into 16 and 8 subjects for the training and test data sets. We have performed threefold cross validation, and each learning is performed with 1,000 epochs. This is our CNN structure used in this study, along with DNN for the comparison. Our CNN structure utilizes the channel patterns in the kernel sizes, adjusted by the EEG channel characteristics. This structure also uses the ReLU activation function except for the last layer, and the last layer uses the sigmoid activation function to classify the data as 0 or 1. We utilize the API provided by Emotive to measure the signal quality data, sensing the accuracy for each channel. The signal quality data is an integer from 0 to 4, for each channel as presented in this table. Each value indicates the accuracy of receiving data. During the EEG measurement, the sensor attachment changes frequently as the subject moves. This condition may not always be perfect for data collection, so we are trying to use signal quality to increase the reliability of EEG data. In order to understand the impact on learning by the signal quality, we have created a set of weights as shown in this table. Weight 0 indicates even weight. Weight 1 and weight 2 models are designed to observe the proportional influence. Weight 3 and weight 4 models are designed to see the inverse proportional influence. We normalize the signal data since each channel has a different scale. As shown in the chart, the collected EEG data have different min-max levels for each channel. We applied two different feature scaling techniques, including min-max normalization and standardization. Also, every data from each subject has a different scale. In order to normalize data from all subjects, we used two scaling methods for the comparison. An individual method performs feature scaling for each subject, whereas integrated method integrates the entire data from all subjects for the feature scaling. For the CNN learning, we convert signal data into an image format. The height represents the 84 EEG channels on 84 pixels, and the width of an image is 128 pixels on the time axis. The purpose of using the CNN algorithm is to discover EEG data patterns causing cyber sickness over time. Therefore, we use the sliding window method at every 64 pixels, as shown in here. Consequently, the images like below came out. We compared two different signals without cyber sickness and with cyber sickness. Similar image patterns are found for each cyber sickness flag. We create 20 different data sets by combining signal weight sets and normalization method. The learning results are presented in the following tables. DNN and CNN both had the best results when signal quality weight set weight 2 and individual standardization technique are combined. In addition, the accuracies of CNN algorithm are slightly better than ones of DNN, but CNN took about 4 hours to run, while DNN took about 2 hours in this study. Besides the signal analysis, we have investigated VR video cases to analyze the screen patterns which cause cyber sickness. We used Emotive Epoch Plus to measure EEG and 4 VR headsets during VR experiences. A total of 6 VR videos were used as stimuli. We created a pixel-based visualization for the segment, where subjects experience cyber sickness as shown here. The vertical axis indicates 6 VR videos, and the horizontal axis represents time. Since the videos utilized in the experiment have different lengths, we normalized the time axis. The color scale represents the number of subjects experiencing cyber sickness in a VR video stream segment. In our experiment, 16 out of 24 subjects have experienced cyber sickness. You can see that there are common segments marked as the blue boxes, where the subjects have experienced cyber sickness. We analyzed the VR video segment mainly when many subjects have experienced cyber sickness at the same time. We then found different interesting patterns. The first pattern is a violent up and down motion. This video shows scenes where subjects in the VR environment felt to ascend into the air and then fell down to the ground. In this case, 5 subjects have experienced cyber sickness. The second pattern is found when the background screen moves quickly. This video shows scenes of riding a roller coaster, and the surrounding background moves at very high speed. 7 subjects have experienced cyber sickness during these scenes. The third pattern occurs when the camera moves against your intentions. This video shows scenes where the camera as a third-person view follow the monster movement. 12 subjects have experienced cyber sickness during the screen transition in an unintended direction. In this work, we proposed a relatively objective measuring model with EEG signals on cyber sickness. From this, we predicted the cyber sickness interval with dim learnings. We also found 3 common patterns causing cyber sickness. Cyber sickness occurs when the up and down movements are violent, when the background changes quickly, and when there are unintended camera movements. At present, we can measure cyber sickness occurrence interval only by EEG data using learning models. We also evaluated 6 VR contents and found the causes of cyber sickness. Based on this, these can be used for user test and evaluation of our various contents. In addition, when creating VR content, we can predict and reduce cyber sickness. In this paper, we have measured and analyzed the occurrence of cyber sickness with EEG data using deep learning algorithms. During the measurement process, we found the suitability of the signal quality weight and pre-processing techniques. The best result comes out when weight 2 and individual standardization pre-processing techniques were applied. Finally, we have found 3 major patterns in the analysis causing cyber sickness. These are our future work plans. We plan to study the personal characteristics of cyber sickness that occur through various experiments. Furthermore, we plan to predict the screen where cyber sickness can occur, and we will increase the number of subjects and secure additional training data. Also, we are planning to conduct evaluation using various contents. This is the end of my presentation. Please refer to the paper for more details. Thank you for your paying attention.
We have time for a quick question. Someone else has?
Hi, thank you for the presentation. I was curious in your data, what did you base your cyber sickness flag in the input and training data on?
Cyber sickness flag is we input the participants. Mm-hmm. participant experience VR, we input keyboard mm-hmm. Cyber sickness flag labeling.
Okay, so during the VR experience, if they felt sick, they should press a button.
Yes.
Okay. Well, thank you.